hypothesis testing. So today is our topic is hypothesis testing. So in statistics we have two major parts. One is descriptive statistics, the another one is inferential statistics. In inferential statistics we have hypothesis testing. So hypothesis testing, what do you mean by hypothesis? So hypothesis is nothing but some statement about a population or an assumption about a population. So hypothesis, what do you mean by hypothesis? A statement about a population or an assumption about a population. So this is called hypothesis. So hypothesis is some statement about a population or an assumption about a population. So what do you mean by statement? So statement is nothing but, for example, the manufacturer of the chalk piece company said that this chalk piece length, that means their products, all the chalk piece have the average length 7 centimeters. So what is the statement? The chalk length is 7 centimeters. So all their chalk pieces are 7 centimeters. So this is this nothing but our statement, which is our hypothesis. In this, we have to check it out, this statement. Otherwise, we have to prove. We are moving to hypothesis testing. So, in hypothesis testing, we are going to test that our assumption. Okay. So, in hypothesis testing, we have some procedure. So, what are the steps involving in the procedures? Step 1 is nothing but set up null hypothesis. What is that? Set up null hypothesis. Step 2, set up alternate hypothesis. Step 3, choose the level of significance. What is that? Level of significance. Step 4, test statistic. And step 5, which is our last step, is nothing but conclusion or inference. So hypothesis testing, we have, these are all the steps. Step 1 is nothing but set up null hypothesis. Step 2 is set up alternative hypothesis. Step 3 is nothing but choose the level of significance. And next one is test statistic. And final one is nothing but conclusion or inference. So now we are going to see one by one. Okay. So first one, set up null hypothesis. What is that? Null hypothesis. It is generally denoted by H naught. So null hypothesis is generally denoted by H naught. So here, what is the null hypothesis means? Hypothesis is of no difference. Hypothesis is of no difference, or there is no significant difference between sample mean and the population mean. is equal to mu. Here, x bar is nothing but our sample mean and mu is nothing but our population mean. Okay, so null hypothesis generally denoted by H naught. So from that we have H naught x bar is equal to mu, which is nothing but sample mean and population mean. There is no significant difference. Okay.
What is our example? The chalk is length is 7 cm. But
conclusion, we have one more point, that is tabulated value. So this result is nothing but our calculated value. Next, we have to find a table value from our statistical tables. In which point? From the level of significance only, we have to find the table value. Suppose the level of significance for our test is 5%, means the table value is nothing but 1.96. So this is our statement, standard table value, and we have to find the calculated from our data values. We have to compare Z and Z alpha. Z is our calculated value, Z alpha is nothing but our tabulated value. So now we have to compare both these two values. From these, our calculated value is less than table value. We have to accept our test norm. What is that? Our calculated value is less than table value. We have to accept our test norm. Okay, otherwise, what is that? We have to reject our test norm. What is our other case? Calculated value is greater than tabulated value. Automatically, we reject the test norm or our statement. Okay? Okay. From these, we have to know what are the steps involving in hypothesis testing. If you have any more doubts, we have to discuss in next hour classes. Okay? Thank you.